When Max rappels from a helicopter to the stage for his Vietnam play, Jason wore a special rig he was told to sit in like a chair.
You feel okay with that?
I feel great.
He had to make the trip up and down several times, pulled by an effects man backstage. Recording sound effects on the set was an important part of the movie. Here, Magnus Buchan's sidekick, played by young Ryan Urquhart, recorded the sound of himself walking with Tic Tacs in his pocket and running with Tic Tacs in his pocket. Between takes, Ryan ate the Tic Tacs and they went out and bought more.
I love for when he's just walking.
Here, makeup man Bob Harper blew tiny crystals into Jason's eyes, irritating them to look red and puffy. For a number of reasons, this technique is generally considered to be obsolete.
Right, here we go, Max. Let's have you in there, please. Let's go.
I quickly learned that while being a fun place to work, a movie set has its pressures like any job, and diversion is always welcome. Here, Wes helped in the pinecone attack on Max. Part of that comes in the form of taking pictures, which happens constantly, especially Polaroids, which are used by wardrobe people, set dressers, and the script supervisor.
You're going to have a documentary about people getting their pictures taken.
I think so.
That'd be a nice little sequence. Mm-hmm. Get a load of this guy. Here, take a load of this. Sure, open. That's great. What's the next big holiday coming up? Valentine's Day? You got to do more red for Valentine's Day?
Maybe.
Pink. Plenty of hardball, huh? We got Lincoln's birthday, Groundhog Day.
Groundhog Day.
Super Bowl. Here's Conti. You can see the sadness on his face.
Bill took up a collection to cheer up the second assistant director, Conti Matal, whose name is often misspelled.
And the good thing is I spelled his name on it, so now people know how to spell his name. I wrote his name on it.
Where are my two guys that I have right here?
C-O-N.
Some crew members played basketball at the hotel court on their off days. Bob Yeoman played on the Duke University squad in college. Here comes Scotty Peterson, the script supervisor, ready to invade the paint. On some days, Bill Murray left the set directly for the golf course.
Once in a while I do.
Even I was not immune from scrutiny. On this day, I was taken to task for wearing my tie too short.
Yeah. I just tied it short. It was underneath the sweater. Wait, you want to turn it on me now? Look, give me my tie. We're talking about it.
Look at that tie.
It's short.
As a musician, Jason Schwartzman has a natural instinct for performing.
Lights! Camera! Background! Action! Everybody in! Rolling!
He ad-libbed this song about the jobs of various crew members relaxing in the room with him. As a minor, Jason was required to spend a certain number of hours each day in school. He should probably have been there now. As part of my publicity job, I conducted interviews with cast and crew. Wes described the search to find Max Fisher, the look of the movie, the music, and other things.
And it was the last day that we, it was literally the last day that we saw kids. I mean, after he came in that day, there were five other kids who were waiting to come in, so I told him to go walk down, up and down the street a few times and come back in while I saw these other five kids, then I brought him back in, and that was the last day we saw anybody, and I knew instantly. He came in wearing a Rushmore blazer with an R that he'd made. So that was a good sign right off the bat. Then we searched all over the place. We did the same thing we did searching for Max. We looked at schools all over the country, all over Canada and all over England. Then my mother sent me pictures of my school And I realized that's what I was trying to find all over those places. I was trying to find one like that. We have two kinds of music we're going to use. One is we're going to score a lot of stuff with this stuff that I think I'm just, that I would call school music, like organ music and those kind of sounds. And then the other thing we're going to use is this British invasion kind of stuff, like the Kinks and the Who and that kind of music, because that gets to the other side of the kid.
The evening Bill Murray finished working on the movie, we decided to conduct our interview in the makeup trailer, the one place where we could find some peace and quiet. After getting his mustache removed and his head shaved, he convinced me to do the same.
So he wants to get out, but the idea that an older man wants to be friend with a high school kid, that's a guy who wants to start over again. He wants to cut off the limb he's on and go back to the root somewhere. He wants to get back down. And I've had that feeling many times, that I wish I could cut it off and start over. He really managed to get great people. There's great people in this movie. He's got great crew. This crew could run a long time together. It's the first one that I can remember where I was really played somebody that was old enough to have children, in a way. I mean, I was old enough always, probably, but the first one where I was definitely someone who could have been relating to his own son.
Just one last thing. Just look right in the camera with one of these.
We are using this finger.
Now they're starting to read even better there, yeah. Unassigned variables.
Good, except when the value of the x-coordinate is equal to or less than the value of 1. Yes, Isaac?
What about that problem?
Oh, that? Don't worry about that. M.
Wait,
is,
why?
I just put that up as a joke. That's probably the hardest geometry equation in the world.
Well, how much extra credit is it worth?
Well, considering I've never seen anyone get it right, including my mentor, Dr. Leakey at MIT, I guess if anyone here can solve that problem, I'd see to it that none of you ever have to open another math book again for the rest of your lives. Max? Care to try it?
I'm sorry, did someone say my name?
Got it.